In this lecture, we'll be covering different cases of the falling chain. This is case one, which is a free fall case. Part of the length of chain is in air and part is on the floor. Say x is on the floor and l minus x is in the air. This is case two, where part of the chain is overhanging, say x, and l minus x remains on the table and part is hanging through the edge of the table. And this is case 3, where there is nothing which is overhanging in the air. The hanging part means the part which has fallen is on the floor. Like in this case, it's in the floor, on the floor, but there is a part which is having a horizontal movement on the table. So these three have different outcomes in terms of the velocity, and we'll find out that velocity. Now, if you look at the case 1, this is a chain when it started falling. It was just touching the tip of the table, and we are ignoring all interactions. Interactions are ignored. We are also presuming there is no loss of energy if at all there is any interaction. First of all, we ignored the interaction. Second thing is that when it is touching the table, when it starts touching the table and starts accumulating here, there is no reaction because the chain is not like a stick. Chain is free and we are ignoring the interaction, so no reaction will be on the chain when it starts hitting the table. So this is the initial position, and when it starts falling, say it falls a distance x, and same distance x will come here, and it has fallen say distance x. So the velocity of this point will be dx upon dt, and the velocity will remain same all through. The entire chain will have the same velocity. There is no stretching, and the acceleration will be d square x upon dt square is the acceleration of this point, which will remain same all through. So these two things we have to remember when we solve this problem. Now let us take the part which is in air and separately the part which is on the ground. This part is on the ground and it has fallen through x, and this is l minus x. So what is the mass of this? If mass per unit length is lambda, lambda is m per unit length. So this will be lambda times l minus x. What is the downward force which is acting on this whole chain which is in the air? This will be the mass lambda l minus x into g is the downward force. There is no reaction, we are presuming the interaction is not here, and so there is no reaction upwards. So what is the net force? This is the net force, which is equal to lambda L minus X into G. Now this net force is causing an acceleration. So mass into acceleration is equal to F net, which is acting on a body. Now what is mass? Mass is lambda L minus X. What is acceleration? Is D square X upon DT square. And what is F net? Is lambda L minus X into G. So these two things get cancelled. So we have an equation where d square x upon dt square is equal to g. In all such cases, wherever you get d square x upon dt square, also always write it as dv upon dt. This is d square x upon dt square, which is the acceleration. And dv upon dt you further write as dv upon dx. Dx upon dt. This is very important. Please keep this relationship in mind. It will be useful in solving such kind of differential equations. And further write this as v. So you can write this as v dv upon dx. So d square x upon dt square, in such problems you will use in many problems you will find this relationship is very handy. Now put this here, v dv upon dx is equal to g, or v dv is equal to g dx. Now simply integrate it, velocity is from 0 to v, and x was 0 initially, and x0 may be the final length which is on the table. So it becomes v square upon 2 is equal to g x 0, or v is equal to twice g x 0 under root. It is same as the velocity of a particle freely falling in air. So this is the velocity of the case 1, the free falling of chain in air. So it is proportional to the square root of 2g into the distance which it has fallen, just like the free fall of the body. Now take the case 2. So here we got v is equal to twice g x0 under root. Let me write it. Now for this case, in this case, let us take at this edge a tension T which acts on both the parts. So this chain which is moving horizontally is pulled by tension T, and this chain which is falling downwards, which is x part, and this is L minus x. This was the edge of the table. I have just broken the two parts separately to understand it better. So this tension T act upwards. So this is lambda L minus x mass, and this is lambda x. Take this first. Net force is F net is equal to mass into acceleration. Acceleration at any point of time will be the, suppose this was the starting point and it moves a distance x which falls. So it will be d square x upon dt square, and velocity is dx upon dt. I am not repeating same method of writing this expression, because from the initial, suppose there was some starting point from where this has moved. Now, these are the two expressions which will be common all through. Now F net in this part is lambda L minus x. Sorry, F net is equal to T. So T is equal to MA, M was lambda L minus x, and A is d square x upon dt square. That is one relationship. Now look at this chain. This chain which is falling, it is not now a free fall case. There is a tension T acting upwards force. The downward force is lambda x g, and the mass is lambda x. So F net here is downwards is lambda x g minus t, which is equal to mass into acceleration, which is lambda x d square x upon dt square. Mass is lambda x here. So write this equation now. Lambda x d square x upon dt square is equal to lambda x g minus t, and the relation, other relationship is this equation. We can write lambda l minus x d square x upon dt square is equal to t. Add these two relationships, we get lambda l d square x upon dt square. On this side, x relationship gets cancelled, and that side we get lambda x g. Now lambda gets cancelled, so we get finally l d square x upon dt square is equal to x g is the relationship which we are getting. So in the earlier thing, if you remember, we got d square x upon dt square is equal to g, and here we are getting l d square x upon dt square is equal to x g, and use the same relationship for this. As I told you, this will become v dv upon dx. So it is l v dv upon dx is equal to x g. It becomes l v dv is equal to x g dx. Integrate it from 0, or say the initial, say there was some initial length x1 and finally it is x2. Initially it was x1, finally it is x2, and the velocity is from 0 to v. So this, when you integrate, you will get the relationship as L v square upon 2 is equal to x2 square minus x1 square upon 2. So here you get this relationship, 2 gets cancelled, so v becomes x2 square and into g. This is into g minus x1 square into g upon l is the velocity for the case 2. Now coming for the case 3, let me write velocity here for case 2 so that we remember it. This was the case 1. Case 2, v is equal to x2 square minus x1 square upon l. And g at under root. So this is the relationship for the second part. Now take the third part. Third part, that way is slightly interesting. Here, take this part, tension, area is tension, and here again, when it is falling, we are ignoring the normal reaction because there is no interaction. What is the mass of this part? Mass of this part is equal to lambda L0, and mass of this part is at any point of time this length will be at any point of time this length will be total length L minus L0 minus X. So at any point of time, if the total length of chain was L, L is the total length, this is X, this is L0, so mass, the length there will be this. So mass here will be lambda L minus L0 minus X, and here it is lambda L0. Now treat these two parts for equation of motion. For this, the equation of motion will be F net is equal to T, and F net is what? Is equal to mass into acceleration, and mass into acceleration here is L minus L0 minus X. Lambda is the mass, and acceleration will be d square x upon dt square, because we are saying that from any starting point at any given point of time it has moved distance x, so acceleration will be d square as in the first case. So I'm not repeating that. That will be equal to tension. Tension is at the corner. Same tension is against this vertical part, but now in the vertical part here in this case only we have to take this mass virtually remains fixed. So this is lambda L0, tension is T upwards, and force is lambda L0 G downwards. So F net here is, F net downwards is lambda L0 G minus T is the downward force, and that is equal to mass into acceleration. Mass is lambda L0 and acceleration is t square x upon dt square. Acceleration of whole chain, this and this part will remain the same. Now again rewrite this equation. Lambda L0 t square x upon dt square is equal to lambda L0 g minus t, and the first equation was L minus L0 minus x d square x upon dt square into lambda is equal to t. Add these two equations, t gets cancelled, so we get, and in this equation L0 gets cancelled, so we get lambda L minus x d square x upon dt square is equal to lambda L0 g is the relationship we get. Lambda gets cancelled as in all the cases. So just see the difference. In the first one we got d square x upon dt square is equal to g. In second one we got l d square x upon dt square is equal to x g. And in third one we are getting l minus x dt square upon dx square upon dt square is equal to l0 g. Now do the same thing. Write this as v dv upon dx. So it becomes l minus x v dv upon dx is equal to L0 g. So it becomes v dv is equal to L0 g dx upon L minus x. Integrate. Let the initial length be 0, means let the initial length be 0, and the final length which has come here be h. So initially let the whole thing was this, the part which has come to the ground was 0, and let final which has come to the ground, let final thing be h. So it becomes v square upon 2 is equal to l 0 g minus log l minus x 0 to h. So it comes as v square upon 2 is equal to minus l 0 g, and this becomes log l minus h upon l. We can write this as l 0 g log l upon l minus h, and this becomes v is equal to twice l 0 g log l upon l minus h under root is your velocity for the third case. So we see three different cases, we get three different results just because of the nature of the overhanging part. The force is exerted by because of those overhanging parts. So these are the three general, very easy cases of hanging chain. Thank you.